it is now March, coming towards mid-March really quickly, and getting towards the end of the snowmobile season. So I am trying to get as many rides in as I can. Today, I've been up with Mo. We are in Millinocket at the New England Outdoor Center. We are unloading the sleds and are going to go to Patten. I'm trying to figure out the best way of unloading this sled. I tried riding it off last time and I got stuck on one of the rungs on my ramps. So this time I stand beside it. And as you're going to see, it takes me right with it. Ends up turning around and almost hitting some cars. I had a hard time stopping it. So I'm not quite sure the best way of doing it. I guess riding it off and having it get hitched up is better than having it run off on me. So I guess I'll ride it off from now on. Now it's time to get saddled up. These are the same saddlebags that I use on my motorcycle. They work really well on the sled as well. So I use these for all my gear. That way I don't have to carry a backpack and get any more tired than I have to on the sled. This sled doesn't have an extended tunnel, so I can't do a box or anything like that. So really, saddlebags are my only choice for gear. Mo is adjusting his mirrors. That's one thing I definitely need to get for this sled. I can't tell what's going on behind me, so I really need at least one mirror. I'd like to have two. I really like the adventure mirrors that you buy for motorcycles with the ram mount grip on them. I think those would be really cool, and I want to get those for both my motorcycle and my sled. That is Mount Katahdin off in the distance. Going around this way, we get a lot of views at a lot of different angles of Mount Katahdin. Never really get close to it though. There's a trail that gets really close to it and goes all the way around Baxter Park, but I've heard from Mo that you don't want to do it this time of year because the trails get really rough.
Dual carbides on yours?
Just one.
Mine's got the fucking dual and it grabs everything.
Yeah, mine's a little jittery too.
Is it? Okay, so yeah. It's just the trail.
Yeah.
It must be.
Yeah.
Alright.
Mm-hmm. So we hit 85 to 112, got on 83, and headed north to Patten. Couldn't ask for better trails. They were smooth, curvy, and fast. Trails are awesome.
They are. It's pretty nice riding.
Yeah.
So that road back there is where we rode in on the motorcycle.
Oh, really?
We came into this trail.
Yep.
This drops down to Whetstone.
Cool.
Here, I believe.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to come down to here.
Well, that's 83, right?
Yeah, but that's 83 south down to there. So this keeps going up this way.
I see.
So if we go over to here, up to Patten, and then come back out this road, and then drop down.
Okay. So we've got like 2 miles, and then like, turn off on 83.
Well, where the hell do we have to go? Oh, there's no link in here, is there? Just 112. Try that on the way back.
Yep.
Go down this way, down the side of the river here, towards Medway, and then take 112 back.
Yep. So Mo was navigating. He's better at it than I am. So he kept track of where we were going and led the way most of the trip. Got us there and back without too many issues. We had to turn around a couple times, but that's okay. And this is the same bridge that we stopped at on the motorcycles when we took a trip from my house in Levant all the way to Patten and spent the night and then came back the next day. Where we stopped last time? Thank you.
was a fun little stretch.
Yep. Any gas?
Not really, no.
I got 3/4 of a tank.
Yeah.
So.
That was a park somewhere over that way. So I can at least see the fucking bike sled.
Okay.
So we decide to repark the sleds where we can see them while we're getting some refreshments in the store, and that requires going up over this little snowbank, which doesn't look like it's going to be too much of an issue. I'd say I went a little too sideways, tipped her over. I count myself lucky that it didn't continue to roll right down the snowbank right on top of me. It was really lucky that it stopped where it did, and I was able to pick it up. I can say that thing is really heavy. I think they're about 550 pounds dry, and so it's not something that you want to be picking up a lot, obviously, but it is doable if you have to. After picking up the refreshments we needed, we headed off back down the trail. Once again, the snowmobile was no worse for wear and was good to go. There were some really good straightaways on this trail, and it made a good mix with the curvy sections, really kept things interesting. Here we turn off onto some single track. After a quick cruise across this pond, we stopped to talk to this fisherman who was ice fishing with his family. He had just set up, so hadn't caught anything yet. We weren't sure how well he was going to do, but wished him luck and headed on. And here we are, coming up to the rental cabin that Mo's parents own. They rent it out to snowmobilers in the winter and ATVers in the summer. It is a great place to stay. Lots of room, great view, and easy connection to all the trails. We just stopped for a quick break. Had a beer on the porch, enjoyed the view, and then headed back. And that is about it for this video. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you next time.